y'all, good morning. So this morning we're working on the brand new Champion generator. Yes, you heard me right, my brand new Champion generator. It's got about 25 hours, I think, on it, maybe even less. The reason I'm gonna have to work on it is because I loaned it to a friend of mine who did not respect my wishes, did not drain the gas after he was done with it, used ethanol gasoline, which I told him not to, and then he also didn't shut down it properly, which clogged up the carburetor. So that was a couple of months ago when I got this, and I needed it back because the hurricane was coming, and I went to go start it to test run it for the hurricane, and sure enough, the generator wouldn't start. So I took the carburetor apart. It's a float bowl carburetor. The needle valve has a little tiny spring in there, and I'm legally blind, so when I had it in my hand, I didn't realize it, and I popped it and I dropped that little tiny spring somewhere here in the yard. It's a tiny, tiny little guy. Well, that ended up taking out my carburetor and the whole generator. So I ended up having another carburetor that had the same spring in it, or close enough, to make it work. So I used that carburetor spring in this carburetor, made it work. I got through the storm fine. However, when everything was better and the storm was over, I contacted Champion and I told them I needed a new carburetor. For some reason, at the time, they were going through a lot of problems with phone calls and stuff, and I ended up having a lot of trouble contacting them, and they were kind enough because of all the issues. They just sent me a brand new carburetor free. The carburetor is like $35. They didn't charge me a dime. They didn't even charge me for shipping. They just sent me a brand new carburetor. So technically, all I need is that little spring to put in this carburetor to make it, you know, but I'm just going to go ahead and put the brand new carburetor on here and start from scratch, and then obviously I'll have the other one as a backup. So I'm going to do that in this video. I will bring you guys along as much as I can. It just depends on the camera angles and stuff, but I'll do my best. It's a super simple kind of process. So hopefully you guys enjoy this and you learn a little something on the way. All right, so let's get started. All right, so the first thing to do is obviously we got to identify the carburetor. The carburetor on this unit is right here. Hopefully you guys can see that. You probably can't. However, it's right down here, right behind the air filter. So the first thing we need to do is remove this air filter housing. Get this out of the way. Set that aside. That works as a good tray to hold the things. It's a little oily, which is normal. That's what you want. You want your air filter to have a little bit of oil on it. Check that, make sure everything's fine here. Everything's good there. Next thing we're gonna do is we're gonna remove these four bolts that are here. So, again guys, I'm gonna do the best I can to film this, but it's a weird angle, so you'll have to hang in with me. So now we're going to remove this piece. Yep, so we're good there. Okay, so now we're going to remove this vent right here. This is a, I don't know if this is a positive, if this puts positive pressure or negative pressure on the filter or what that is, but we need to remove it. So get that out of the way and just kind of tip it up out of the way like that. So next we got to remove these two bolts here. And because I'm just using one of these cheap tool sets, my tools got stolen in my truck. I lost my whole toolbox. I got to make it do, but you can see it don't really need a whole lot to get this apart. Just loosen those bolts, nuts, excuse me. Oh yeah. Okay, so there's a bolt down here, guys. You don't have to remove that bolt. You just have to wiggle this enough to kind of get it to loosen to let it fall down. The next thing you want to do is you want to be careful with your gasket. And we're going to pull off the carburetor. Alright guys, so now we are going to just take our hands in here and gently move this sideways and pull this rod up. And then you've got this little spring that comes out, and just set that aside. That's all you have to do. Now your carburetor is going to be free. Take it out. You want to be very careful with your gaskets. Okay, so there's the back gasket. I wish these came with new gaskets. It should have, but it didn't. So I'm going to reuse these. All right, just so that I can video this. Next thing you're going to do is you're going to grab your fingers or whatever, loosen that thing right there for your line, your fuel line, and then twist your fuel line off. Sometimes you got to take the pliers, kind of twist it a little bit. Just go easy. And there you have it. There has your old carburetor is off. Okay, so now we're going to replace the new one. First thing we're going to do is put the gasket back on. Wait, we took it off. Obviously, basically, we're just doing everything in reverse of what we just did. This goes to the back. This is where your little spring connects to that first hole. So I like, oh yeah, on your new one, it's going to have a little cover on the gas line. Slip that back on. Take that, push that down like that. Hopefully you guys can see that. It's very difficult to video this. But anyways, put your fuel line back on. Take your carburetor, line it back up. You're gonna get your little spring on. I like to put the little spring on first and then put on the little rod. But your mileage may vary. All right, so basically we have it back together. Back there anyways. So next step is going to be, oh, that's loose. Okay, so your next step is going to be to obviously just go ahead and put this back on. Now mine is ripped. I'm gonna have to get another one of these, but for the time being, the other half of the gasket is back there, so it'll be okay. That's all right. All right, so I'm just gonna simply put this back into place. Gonna make sure to put this back on, which this is your control for your choke, so you definitely want to do that. Okay, now that we got that back on, all right, so now that we have all this back in place, obviously we're just going to reverse everything we just did, continue to do that same process. First we're going to replace these bolts. Hand tighten them. Like I said, I'll buy a gasket for there. I could probably make one out of RTV too, but I'll just buy one. Okay, so we're tightening those back up. You don't want to go crazy tight, guys. You just want them tight. And don't overdo them. Do a little bit on, like, a couple of turns on one and then a couple of turns on the other. You do want it snug, though, because you want to squish that gasket. Those two gaskets. But you don't want to He-Man that. Nice and secure there. So now we're going to put our air filter back on. Make sure you get it in there. Take your four screws. And this is easier when you're not filming and the camera's right in your way. All right, there we go. Replace our air filter. Replace the cover. Lock back down. Did the same thing for your bottom. There you have it. You have successfully replaced the carburetor. Yeah. Alright guys, so here you go. First time on video. First time to try it. We're doing it on video. Alright guys, so there you have it. Generator is up and running. 121 volts, works perfect. 60 hertz like it was supposed to. Everything went great on this. I did the best I could filming it. It was a little difficult. Hope you guys enjoyed the video. If you do have any questions, comments, concerns, you know what to do. Leave them below. Thanks a whole lot. Take care and God bless.